And good afternoon, everyone. Governor Terry Branstad asked lawmakers to boldly change Iowa schools.
He did, and today the House answered, passing a big educational reform bill that Eric Hansen explains has the potential to change a lot in your neighborhood school. Eric?
Yeah, Cynthia, the 81-page bill that narrowly passed the House this morning would change how students are tested, how teachers are evaluated, and when third graders can move to fourth grade. And that's just the beginning.
After months of homework, weeks of teamwork, and hours of debate, school reform passed the House.
This bill will not solve all of Iowa's educational problems, but it's a step in the right direction.
One big change embraces competency-based learning, which lets students advance when they master a subject, not just when they put in so many hours.
We support the whole idea of competency-based learning. That's exciting, it's new, it's innovative, it is something we should be behind.
A lot of the districts are trying that right now, and it seems to be a good way to go and a good thing to look into.
Another centerpiece, third graders would have to prove they can read before going to fourth grade.
We want to put those support systems in place to make sure that children, by the time they're in ending grade three, truly are where they need to be. And their skills.
Teachers and administrators would be evaluated every year instead of every three. High school grads would first take tests to make sure they're ready for college or career. And task forces would review the length of school days, school years, and online schools. Every Democrat voted no, some saying it doesn't go far enough.
Being bold without meaningful, sustainable reform has the potential to create backward movement instead of forward movement.
But Republicans passed it, saying students will benefit.
I do describe it as a transformational bill. This has a lot.
And now it moves on to the Senate, where they have some similar ideas and some very different ideas as well. Everyone is convinced it'll take a conference committee to hammer out any differences before it then gets to the governor, but they're also convinced it will get to his desk.
Not over yet. Thanks.